The week of April 12th through the 18th is Colorado's Severe Weather Preparedness Week, as proclaimed by Governor Hickenlooper. During this week, National Weather Service offices in Colorado will be promoting information about potentially hazardous severe weather and related safety guidelines. Lightning usually injures and kills more people each year in Colorado than any other thunderstorm-related hazard, and this is also true within most other western states. In 2014, there were 2 documented fatalities and 12 reported injuries from lightning in Colorado. Although most people survive a lightning strike, many survivors suffer long-term problems such as neurological disorders, muscle damage, including heart damage, and injuries to the nervous system. When thunderstorms threaten, seek shelter in a sturdy non-metal building or a metal-roofed vehicle. Then make sure that all windows and doors are closed, since lightning can pass through an open airway. It is recommended that you err on the side of caution and wait at least 30 minutes after the last sound of thunder before resuming outdoor activities. A recent study on lightning victims concluded that 95% of the people who were struck by lightning while outdoors had a substantial building or vehicle nearby. Again, when thunderstorms threaten, seek shelter immediately. Floods and flash floods are the second leading direct weather cause of death and injury in the western part of the United States. Flash floods can occur many miles away from where the heavy rain is falling. You need to pay close attention to the weather situation when hiking through narrow canyons, gullies, or arroyos on days when heavy rainfall is possible. If flash flooding becomes likely, you should quickly move to higher ground. And never attempt to cross a flooded roadway. It can be nearly impossible to see through the floodwaters to determine if the road has already been washed out. Additionally, just 2 feet of fast-moving water will carry away most vehicles. When approaching floodwaters, turn around. Don't drown. All thunderstorms have downdrafts, which can sometimes produce very strong winds. This includes microburst winds, which can produce gusts up to 100 miles per hour, which is as strong as winds in an EF1 tornado. These strong thunderstorm winds can cause great destruction to property and forests and can pick up loose objects and turn them into airborne missiles. When thunderstorms threaten, seek shelter immediately. Although tornadoes occur only rarely west of the Continental Divide, it is a fact that they actually do occur somewhere on the west slope each year, such as this tornado, which was photographed in northwest Colorado on May 29th of 2013. If a tornado is spotted or if a tornado warning has been issued for your area, seek shelter in a basement or underground storm shelter. If these options are not available, move to a hallway or a small interior room on the lowest floor, such as a closet or bathroom. Abandon modular homes and mobile homes, as they offer little protection from tornadoes. If you are driving in open country and see a tornado, simply drive away from the tornado path if time permits. Large hail can occur from very strong thunderstorms. In Colorado, large hail is most common in the eastern plains, although it can occur on the west slope. In September of 2013, hail up to tennis ball size occurred in La Plata County and caused around $2 million in damage to personal property. Hailstones of similar size also struck an area near Blanding, Utah in 2013, as shown in the photo on the right. Large hail can injure and sometimes even kill. Again, when thunderstorms threaten, seek shelter before they arrive. As a reminder, you should check the latest weather forecast before planning any outdoor activity, and then you should keep an eye on the sky and be prepared to quickly seek shelter when conditions threaten. For more information on severe weather safety, please visit the Weather Safety menu item on our homepage. The National Weather Service wishes you a safe, severe weather season.